Hi children, good morning. Dear students, today let us start the topic, the peninsular plateaus. Our India physical diversity is the lesson. In that, we already studied about the physical features of India. Okay, in that we already studied that northern mountains and northern plains. Now today the topic is peninsular plateaus. Dear children, can you see this map? Yes, in this map, you see that there is a pink color totally from here to here. This shows that this is called as a peninsular plateau. See, what are the things you are going to see in this? Can you see this? Narmada, Tapi, Godavari, Krishna, Kaveri. Okay, these are the rivers found in the peninsular plateau. And one more thing we are going to observe here. Here there is Malwa plateau is there, and here there is a Deccan plateau. Means here very important thing is Narmada Soni Rift Valley divides into the peninsular plateau into two major parts, children. Here which one is that? Narmada Soni Rift Valley. This is the valley. See children, this is the valley. It divides the peninsular plateaus into two parts. One is the Malwa plateau, which is in the north side part of the peninsular plateau, and this is southern parts of the peninsular plateau, that is called as the Deccan plateau. And one more thing we are going to observe here, Aravalli range. Okay, this Aravalli range is lies to the northwest of Malwa plateau. Yes, this is lies in the northwest place of the Malwa plateau. And here see one more thing, Vindhyas. This is the Vindhya. This is also a range. This is situated in the south part of the Malwa plateau. And here there is, can you see this triangle shape, children? Yes, this is called as the Mount Guru Shikara, the highest peak in the Aravallis. Which is the highest peak in the Aravallis? Tell me, that is Mount Guru Shikara. Understood? Next one. Here, the Satpura, Michael, Rajmahal, Amarakantaka range lies to the north of Deccan Plateau. See, in the north of Deccan Plateau, we can see that here Satpura, Michael, Rajamahala, Amarakantaka ranges. But here they are not shown, but it is already situated in the Deccan Plateaus. Next, can you see the Ghats, children? Ghats section, green color, dark green. This eastern side, east side of the Ghats section we are calling as the Eastern Ghats. West side we are calling as the Western Ghats. Here, the Anamalai, Kardamom, Palani Hills are to the south of Western Ghats. In the south of Western Ghats, we can see here, Anamalai. See here, Anamalai is there, Anamudi. Okay, Anamalai, Kardamom, Palani Hills are famous here. And in the Western Ghats and Eastern Ghats, where it meets, that is called as a Nilagiri Hills. That is, we are calling as the Ooty Udagamandala. You know that? Ooty? Yes, this is the famous hill station where Western and Eastern Ghats, where there is a Western and Eastern Ghats meets. Okay. And many rivers of peninsular India have their sources in the Western Ghats also. See children, so many rivers are there in the peninsular plateaus, that is Godavari. This is also river, Krishna, Kaveri, Narmada, Tapi. Yes, these are the rivers present in the peninsular plateaus. Which valleys divides the peninsular plateaus into two parts? That is called as the Narmada Soni Rift Valleys divides the peninsular plateaus into two parts. One is the Malwa Plateau and one more is the Deccan Plateau. And in this region, which is the highest peak in the Aravallis? Means Mount Guru Shikara. Mount Guru Shikara is the highest peak in the Aravallis. Next, one more question is will be arising in the Malwa Plateau. In the northern part is in the northern northern part, and it is in the Malwa Plateau is in the northern part, and southern part is in the Deccan part. Okay. Next, what are the characteristics? Then what purpose we are calling as a plateaus? What is it having some characters? Because of that only we are calling as a plateaus. We are calling as a mountains, range, like that. It is upland with the extensive almost all levels for surface, which is bounded by steep slopes. Means always it is the almost all its surface is very level, and it is bounded by the steep slope. slopes, means its a boundary is always in the slope portion. This landform is a extensive area of relative flat land. See children, always this area is in the flat land. The Deccan Plateau is the largest plateau in India. Yes children, which plateau is the largest plateau in India, tell me? That is called as a Deccan Plateau, and it is made up of ancient hard rocks. This plateau is made up of ancient hard rocks. Which plateau it is? Deccan Plateau. Next, advantages. What are the advantages of these plateaus? This peninsular plateau is a rich in minerals. Yes children, because it is having the flat land, flat surface, level surface it is having, almost all, so many rivers are also present in this area, as well as this is having the rich minerals. The rivers flowing across it helpful for the cultivation of crops. Yes, always in the river side, means the river bank of the river, the population is more because of that plenty of water. All of you know that already, I explained this one. Because of the plenty water, this water is helpful for the agriculture field, industrial purpose, in all the activities of human, it is very helpful. Therefore, this river, flowing of this rivers is helpful for the cultivation of crops. There are many waterfalls which are useful for the generation of hydroelectricity. See children, yes. This plateaus, in the plateaus there are the many waterfalls are there. This is useful for the generation of the hydroelectricity. With the help of waterfalling, they are synthesizing, means they are generating the electricity. It is favorable for agriculture, rearing of animals and industries. See children, why it is favorable for agriculture, rearing animals and industries? Because of the plenty water children. Because they are having the plenty of water, this water is there, means that water we can use for the agriculture purpose, and we are using for the rearing of animals, and industry peoples also, they are using this river water. Okay, several empires also ruled in the peninsular plateaus. Yes children, that is also true. Maurya, Gupta and all the in the previous class I explained that so many empires are ruled in these areas. Okay, that is Rashtrakuta, Chalukyas, Hoysalas, Vijayanagara, Kadamba, Ganga, Bahamani Sultana established their empires here. See children, Rashtrakutas, Chalukyas. Once again I will read you. Rashtrakutas, Chalukyas, Hoysalas, Vijayanagaras, Kadambas and Gangas, Bahamani Sultans established their empires here. Yes, already in next year, next higher class, you will study all these things. Where they are, where there's empire. Okay, all about this, you are studying about this. Means, this peninsular plateau is very useful for us. Here, their population is way more because of this rivers. Understood? Answer the following questions. Mention the name of two important plateaus of India. Yes, just now you studied, that is Malwa Plateau and Deccan Plateau. Malwa Plateau is in the north side and Deccan Plateau is in the south side. Okay. Mention the important historical places located in the peninsular plateau. See children, historical places is, just now I said, Satpura, Maikal, Rajmahala, Amarkantaka Ranges, and these are the historical places. Then this Mount Gurushikara, this also some historical important places are situated in the peninsular plateaus. Yes children, in this class you studied about the peninsular plateaus. Thank you.